From NBC News, this is Today.
By the way, our crack maintenance staff,
yes,
we have fixed
these messages.
Has never owned a video game and rarely finds time for the couch because at 15 years old, he's just become the youngest person to climb the seven highest mountains on the seven continents. So the last climber is now joining us along with his dad, Paul Romero, and stepmom, Karen Lundgren. And good morning to all of you guys.
Good morning. Well, good morning.
Thanks, I've got
to ask you, yeah, it's great to have you back. And what a Christmas present this must have been for you to be up there. I mean, really, finally making your dream come true. What was that moment? After what, how has it been? Has it been 6 years? You started this when you were nine. What was that moment like for you?
You know, it was after working for six hard years and then to be standing on the summit of Mount Vinson on Christmas Eve on top of Antarctica, which is the most beautiful place I've ever been to, and I'm sure they could agree as well, but to be with them on top of the summit was, you know, together and just knowing that we finally completed was amazing.
You know,
amazing
to
feeling.
To have a number one, and then you're smiling because it was, you know, they were clearly on that tape. These wonderful moments that you were able to share together. I mean, Paul, you're shaking your head. What's your takeaway?
I'm shaking my head in disbelief. I'm still numb at it. I'm the proudest father, proudest stepmom on the planet here to have a 15-year-old son here that has such aspirations and goals and stays fixed on them. A lot of kids have big goals that just take 90-degree turns or 180-degree turns off them. We've stayed fixed on this, George.
On this thing. And you parents kept encouraging him to get back on track when those times happen.
But you two are experienced.
So how did you know to keep pushing him when you understand clearly from your own experience the risk
involved? It's a fine line for a parent to work with a kid and push them just hard enough to do something great, you know, and to feel good about it, but not push them.
We think we do our homework and our track record shows it a little bit.
So if it's your lifestyle, then what's next? You're going to chill for a while, maybe learn how to play some video games? Or are you now going to start I saw that finger. Are you not? You went like this.
No.
I mean, are you going to set new goals?
Well, yeah, there will be definitely more goals. There will definitely be more goals in the future. I'm looking at the South Pole in the future.
Oh.
But right now I'm just going to be kicking it back, you know, not kicking it back, but just taking time, you know, probably take some time skiing as well and kind of settle it.
Yeah.
But my main goal is to still keep inspiring kids, and I want kids to be fired on goal setting and to find their own Everest.
Find your own Everest, which is something that you and your family have young people to figure out what their goals are.
Yeah, not to climb Mount Everest, but of course to set goals in life and to be driven to know that anything is possible.
Anything is possible. That's your takeaway.
Mm-hmm.
So that's the.
There's a family. It's not all just about me. You know, we're the first family to climb these seven summits. So.
Wow.
I
don't even know what to say to you guys. And you're absolutely right. What a legacy, and for you, and for you, and thank you so much, all three of you, for being here this morning.
You
made us all smile.
It's our honor.
It's my honor. And coming up next, five reasons you should dive back into the stock market in 2012. We'll check it out after local news.